is ticking, tick, tick, tock, it's time to choose. Come take the stab, live while you can, what have you got to lose? Let's make it feel.
Spider in the Hall, Deal the Devil. This is one of his new songs he had me play when he was on a few episodes ago. So, I gotta play it first. You guys didn't, because he didn't submit to MusicSUBMIT.com because I got it first. Haha. Anyway. Mike's on the phone, on the side, on from MusicSUBMIT.com. He's laughing at the side of me because I'm sitting there singing in his ear horribly. So,
good.
Yeah, so that's the Spider in the Hall. I had you listen to this guy because I'm telling you, this song is actually superb. So if this song is gonna go places where I'm telling him, what do you do for songs like this? Is it the same thing, or do you send it to radio stations? What do you do?
What do we do for songs like what we just heard, Spider in the Hall? Yeah, we listen to. I think we would call that like an alt indie electro. Indie rock, you know, it's not, it's a lot of music crosses, more than one genre. In fact, most music does. So we select, you know, what we think best fits it and then send it out. And, you know, any site that's looking for that music in that range, they might get this artist to listen to. And so, you know, we just try to get the music out there and give it a chance, put some human ears on it, you know?
Mm-hmm. Now, after musicians has submit to a radio station, blog, or whatnot, after they do that, do they continue to submit it, or can they just get a hold of the person? Like, for example, sometimes they get a hold of me and they just submit their songs to me. So do they do the same thing over and over again, or do they have that connection, or they just send it to me, or how's that happen?
Yeah, you know, once an artist develops a relationship with someone like you, Charles, we're happy to have made that connection, you know? Mm-hmm. And anytime this band, if they were to contact you outside of us and say, hey, I got a new music, would you mind playing? You want to check it out? It's been awesome, you know? It's great. That's the whole idea, just for us to just sort of make connections between the bands and the sites that are looking for indie music, the ones that are looking to play underground stuff, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And once that's made, then we're happy. You know, we found a good band, the artist found a good resource, and you know, hopefully you're fast friends.
Yeah. Most of my bands I've been playing on my show has become friends, so it's very cool. My new music family.
Well, it's hard. I mean, how many bands hit you up, you know, just ask, can you please check me out? Please check me out.
Oh, my gosh.
And you're overwhelmed. I mean, you know, how many would you say?
Tell you the truth, before I was trying to get people to understand, I need you guys to go to MusicSUBMIT.com and fill out the form. But since no one was actually understanding that and didn't know really what you were, I mailed my old form up on my old WordPress blog, which is going to go down tonight because I didn't know I was actually still up. I got hit like a lot of bands. And right. I mean, tons of it. And it's not even on your site. It's on my own land. Like, oh, my God. That's a lot of people. And then on you guys, I get maybe, I think I get a notification maybe once, maybe three emails from you guys a day.
Mm-hmm.
I think I got two more just before the show.
Oh, okay.
So I cool. can't, I don't really have a number because I really don't know. I just see like, oh my God, this is a lot of people.
Yeah. I mean, if it's in the hundreds or even the thousands, it can be, it's meant, you know, trying to get back to every person in your emails is difficult. And everybody sends different things. They send links, they send YouTube, they send, files and MP3 files, you know, and all kinds of things go to my website. And so, the advantage to you guys of reviewing through the advantage to the bands to using a service like MusicSUBMIT is that it makes it easier on people like Shelf. Because now they have a consistent format to listen to the music and decide if, you know, if it's something they want to use.
Now, what if young bands are coming out? Because there's always new bands coming out with new ideas and trying to get their way. If they don't know how to do a press kit, does MusicSUBMIT help them with that?
Yeah, sure. You can call our support. We usually pick up and walk you through anything that you're having trouble with. If it's songs aren't streaming or picks aren't loading or anything, really, we'll help you out, walk you through it. It's really pretty easy, and a band should be able to create a campaign in, you know, less than 5 minutes.
Okay, awesome.
Yeah.
Cool. All right, guys, be right back for more MusicSUBMIT. When we get back, I got to take this commercial break. Be right back. I think I said that twice now. Huh.
Let's Talk About the Music is wanting your sponsorship to advertise on the show's podcast. Anyone, anywhere in the world can advertise. We're especially looking for small businesses, event and festival coordinators, and venues. For pricing and special offers, go to letstalkaboutthemusicblog.wordpress.com.
Join us Wednesday, March 30th for a special tribute episode of Let's Talk About the Music. This show is dedicated to Jamie Hartley, a strong young woman with a lovely voice and a big heart. Jamie suffered from epidermolysis bullosa, or EB. An inherited disorder that causes the skin to be extremely fragile, like butterflies' wings. Hear the story of Jamie Hartley live Wednesday, March 30th from 8 p.m. to midnight Pacific Standard Time at letstalkaboutthemusic.com.
Well, that was some boring music.
Spike!
Come on, where's the Justin Bieber? Where's the Katy Perry? Where's the Fallout Boy?
Noddle, you have witch powers. Turn him into a chipmunk and feed him to the owl outside.
I will do no such thing. We're here to talk about our website.
HomeCanineNeutering.com?
What?
No! InvaderPet.com, where people can check out our comic strips or locate bookstores selling bookmarks with our comics on them. So, listeners, want to see comics of me, Noddle the Witch, my pets Kaylee Cat and Spike Beagle? Go to InvaderPet.com and check us out.
Seriously, though, you guys really have a canine neutering website?
Live in studio on April 26, 2016. We're going local, everybody. Seattle's very own Johnny Sonic. That's right, guys. Johnny Sonic's going to be on the air with me, your host. We're going to talk about politics, music, and his charity coming up. Right here, Let's Talk About the Music on April 26th. Don't want to miss it. Seattle's very own Johnny Sonic.